Hey everyone, this is Jason, and we are playing Fallout New Vegas. And right now it's pretty loud, so we'll just let this intro go on through, and then I'll come back when the intro's over with. Alright.
Changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn, training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business, under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier, hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene. From where you're kneeling must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
So there it is, the intro, and I'll just give you a little background on what I'm doing here. I'm sure if you're looking at this video, then you're already familiar with Fallout New Vegas. I mean, this is an older game. It's older than the other playthrough I was trying to go through, and I think we're about to have a cutscene, so let's watch this. also need to turn the main volume down because it's like killing my ears.
How about that? Whoa, easy there, easy. You've been out cold a couple of days now. Why don't you just relax a second? Get your bearings. Let's see what the damage is. How about your name? Can you tell me your name?
Okay, so as a name, we are going to stick with my my nickname in real life. This is my stage name. I'm actually in a band, so. JT Corpse.
Huh. I can't say it's what I'd have picked for you, but if that's your name, that's your name.
Yep.
I'm Doc Nixon. Welcome to Good Springs. Now, I hope you don't mind, but I had to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out. I take pride in my needlework, but you'd better tell me if I left anything out of place. How'd I do?
Okay, so I'm not really concerned about how I look, because we're not really going to see how I look that much. I mean, I don't plan on it. I'm going to make him female. It's going to be female, and I am going to... Let's see, I forgot how to just randomize a look. Caucasian is fine. So randomize. Randomize my head. No. I don't like it. Randomize. No. See, that everyone's just... The whole thing's just ugly. All of them are ugly. Ugh. Alright, what is a hero gonna look like? Let's see. Maybe he can look like this. That's fine, I think that's even what we started with. What about age? We'll keep him as a spunky young person. Facial hair, gunslinger. He's not gonna be a gunslinger. Survivalist. Let's do the survivalist. And hairstyle. Let's do. Let's do the buzzsaw. Buzzsaw is fine. Yes. Yeah, so what I was thinking with this character. Okay. Let me go back a step. Yeah, so most of you are probably familiar with Fallout New Vegas anyways. So, what I'm going to do in this gameplay is I'm going to play a specific type of character, and I'm using a Project Nevada modification. That's the only mod I'm using right now. I may add more as the game progresses, but I'm going to try to play this on the hardest mode I can, Legendary or whatever it was. I haven't played this in years. So, several years, and so we'll adjust that as it comes around. I really wanted to set up my mods, and I haven't had a chance to do that just yet, but we will go through this character introduction first, and go and get that over with. So, we're going to stick with this guy, and I'll explain what I'm going to do as with him, what I plan to do with him as we go along. Yes.
Well, I got most of it right anyway. Stuff that mattered. Okay. No sense keeping you in bed anymore. Let's see if we can get you on your feet. Good. Why don't you walk down to the end of the room, over by that vigor tester machine there.
The vigor tester.
It ain't a race.
Vigor tester.
You're looking good so far.
Yeah.
Go ahead and give the vigor tester a try.
Okay.
We'll learn right quick if you get back all your faculties.
Okay, so what I'm looking for, a strong, he's gonna be a bully. He's gonna be this large guy who just charges in. He's gonna do mainly melee weapons. I want him to have a high endurance, a high strength, and I want him to be a raging drug addict and alcoholic. And I'm gonna try and not have him either go for NCR or Legion. He's just gonna try to play the game. He wants revenge. on the person who killed him. So that's what his main focus is. He could give a shit about the NCR. He's just worried about getting double-crossed. And this is a big guy. They screwed with the wrong guy, and now everyone's gonna pay. And even if he's just gonna be the biggest asshole to everyone too. This isn't gonna be a nice guy throughout this playthrough. So if you're expecting some kind of heroic champion to save people all the time, it ain't getting done. He may save people, but it may be purely for money if he needs it, or he'll just turn down stuff. He may even kill the person who's asking for the help. That's how this is going to be played out. So first of all, we need him strong. I have 5 points to spend. I'm going to jump up to Circus Strongman. This will enable him to have do great in melee and as well carry more stuff. Actually, let's take it down one notch because we want to jump ahead. Perception, I'm not worried about. You know what? I'm not worried about sneaking either, you know? Well, I guess that this is for when, explosives, lockpick, energy weapons, accuracy. See, this is, I'm gonna take one out of here. I'm gonna be an unsuspecting trout. That'll give me an extra point. Endurance, I do want endurance. This affects my unarmed, my health, my resistance, and survival. So I want at least tough as nails. Go to charisma. Charisma, I do not care about. We will take that down 2 points, actually. We are a creepy undertaker. This guy has no social skills whatsoever. Intelligence, we're taking it down. We'll leave it at knucklehead. He's a knucklehead. agility. I like agility. I'm going to take it up 2. Luck. I like luck. We're going to take it up. I think we'll take it up 2. And we have one more point to spend. And it's not going to be luck. It's not going to be agility. Certainly not intelligence. Certainly not charisma. I'm thinking either endurance or strength. It might be strength. Actually, I may take one more out of perception. Explosives, lockpick, energy, accuracy, compass ring, yes. Squinting Newt. This guy, we're gonna put one more in strength and one more in endurance. This guy is hardy, powerful, and just does not give a goddamn shit about anything. JT Corpse. We'll just call him Corpse for short, if we call him anything. And we are good.
Surprised anybody'd want to tangle with you. Heck, you could go Deathclaw hunting with a switch. Well, we know your vitals are good. But that don't mean them bullets didn't leave you nutter than a bighorn and drop it. What do you say you take a seat in my couch and we go through a couple of
questions? Still barking. Okay. Well, let's see what's going on. And alright, so let's have a sit.
Alright. I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind. Dog.
Let's see. Dog, cat, kick.
House.
Demolish.
Night.
Night. Let's see. Campfire.
Enemy.
Enemy. Crush. I like crush. Crush or stab? Crush.
Light.
Flash, torch, beam, light. Let's just go for torch.
Mother.
Human shield.
Sometimes when you give tests like this, you learn more than you was hoping for, and I reckon that ain't always the best thing.
Well.
But I guess maybe it explains a thing or two about your predicament.
I'm a badass hombre, sir.
Okay. Now, I got a few statements. I want you to tell me how much they sound like something you'd say. First one, conflict just ain't in my nature.
Strongly disagree.
I ain't given to relying on others for support.
Strongly agree.
I'm always fixin' to be the center of attention.
I disagree.
I'm slow to embrace new ideas.
I'd agree.
I charge in to deal with my problems head on.
I strongly agree on that one.
Almost done here. What do you say you have a look at this? Tell me what you see.
Let's see. This looks like an oozing wound.
Okay.
I'm too embarrassed to say what it looks like.
Last one.
This looks like a mushroom cloud.
Well, that's all she wrote.
It is all she wrote.
You don't have nothing to compare it to, so maybe you'd better just have a look at the results. See if it all seems right to you.
Alright, so they put me in melee. They gave me speech. I do not want speech. Unarmed. I'm not planning on fighting hand-to-hand. I want to use melee weapons, primarily. So let's go and take it out of unarmed. I do want to craft things, though. I do want to craft, because I know I'm not going to have anything in barter. It's going to be hard for me to really buy stuff. It's going to be hard for me to pick locks or anything. It's going to be hard for me to, you know, do a lot of stuff. So I want survival, definitely. And let's see. Speech, no. Sneak, no. Science, no. Maybe repair. Maybe a little in guns wouldn't hurt, but barter. Let's go with repair. So we got some melee weapon skills. Yeah. A lot of people are probably smacking their faces right now saying, oh my god, he just chose the most horrible skills. But you know what? I'm playing this how I think my character would be. So this is how I think he's going to be.
Before I turn you loose, I need one more thing from you. You got a form for you to fill out so I can get a sense of your medical history. Just a formality. Ain't like I expect to find you got a family history of getting shot in the head.
Oh, for Pete's sakes. Okay, so these are traits you can get. They have like positive and negative effects on you. Good natured. No, I'm not good natured. Heavy-handed. Your melee and unarmed attacks do more damage but less critical damage. See, that doesn't sound good to me. I like critical damage. Kamikaze. You have plus 10 action points, but your reckless nature causes you have... No, I want to be... Like a tank. That's what I want to be. Small frame, no. Trigger discipline, no. Probably the only thing I'm going to get is... Probably what everyone else probably gets is... Wild Wasteland. Yeah. I think that's about all... We're going to do.
All right, I guess that about does it. Come with me, I'll see you out.
Okay. So, I guess I can pick up stuff. Throw it down. Yeah, so I have to get used to the controls again, and so this was just to set up the character, and I appreciate you guys tuning in and watching. Now I'm going to go set up these mods and start getting ready, and I'll come back when either I'm almost out or right when I'm about to leave here. Alright, thanks everyone. Bye.